Hi guys, welcome back. I'm the Keg Man, and let's look at what we've done so far. So in the previous episode, we've done a little bit of scouting. We've done a little bit of working around what we're going to have. We built our tactic. We played a friendly. I'm going to show you who we have signed so far. So in a previous episode, I think you saw we signed Ben Foster. I only recorded it like a half an hour ago. So we picked up Ben Foster as a replacement for Adrian. Haven't sold Adrian yet. Trying to. No one wants him. We also picked up Andrea Papetti from Brescia for £1.8 million. Now, this is an interesting player. We actually signed while he's on a youth contract. His compensation, I think, is up to 4.5, but not a bad little centre-back there. I then picked up Nicolò Rivella, also on a youth contract. Another Italian here, also very good as a bit of centre-mid cover. I decided to get Benoit Badiashile as well. He's decent. We might end up selling Matip, and he's going to replace Matip straight away. And then we'll have the other Italian youngster there. I say other Italian youngster, this guy's French. Guess what? Another youngster on a youth contract in Italy. Martin Palumbo cost me 700k up front, and what a player he is for 18 years old. I think he's going to develop quite well, but we'll see how he gets on. And finally, I managed to convince my board to spend £41 million on Fran Beltran. I literally said, we want this player. He's going to be able to replace James Milner. And they were like, you know what? You're right. Yeah. So we've got him in. He's going to be the long-term replacement in this one season save for James Milner. But because he's 21 years old, I don't have to register him for the Premier League team. So this is where we stand at the moment. It's a fairly bloated squad. We are trying to sell Adrian, obviously. Let's bring Ben Foster on the bench. We are trying to sell Adrian. We've got a few injuries we're worrying about. Thiago's going to be out for a few days. Naby Keita's out for a couple of weeks. Chamberlain's out for 2 months. Shaqiri's out for 5 weeks. And Diogo Jota had a little concussion. He's out for another 4 days. Financially, we're looking good. £96 million in the bank. We've only got £500,000 of our transfer budget left. I'm overspending on my wages, so I don't know what I can do there. Games-wise, we've only played 4 friendlies. We won a 2-0, 4-0, 6-0 against Sevilla, and a 4-0 against Utrecht. Today, we're going to be taking on Arsenal in the Community Shield because, well, it's the first competitive game, even if it is basically a glorified friendly. Dynamics are looking good. Cohesion's getting there. The atmosphere in the club is muy buen. I don't know why I said it like that, but the managerial support is there as well. I've not touched the staff, not intending to. So, getting into the tactical meeting beforehand, they're telling me that we should change from attacking to a positive and increase defensive duties. I'm not going to. So, we're going to set up with a team. We're going to go quick pick real quick. What we got here? I want Adrian, no. I want Ben Foster in there. Van Dijk, Gomez, Alexander Arnold, Robertson. To be expected, Fabinho, Henderson, Milner, Salah, Mane, and Firmino. Now, I am allowed 7 bench players, so I'm going to have Tsimikas. Nico Williams, we'll have Origi, possibly Wijnaldum or Beltran. I think we'll go Minamino and Beltran out for Origi, which gives me cover for everywhere, which is the main thing right now. Okay, we're looking positive here. The tactics, they're pleased. Wijnaldum's pleased. Minamino's happy with his traits. We're all good. Right, I think we're going to go for a pump fists. Do it for the fans. We'll follow it up with a outstretched... No, we can't do outstretched arms. We'll follow it up with a hands together, I have faith. Not too much going on. And it's kickoff. Okay, first highlight of the game. Virgil van Dijk finds Mo Salah. What a goal. What a lovely finish there. I'm not arguing with that. I'm very happy with that. I love a free kick. I love a free kick. Set piece simulator again this year, maybe. Also, I'm loving the representation of this away kit for Liverpool here, even if I don't like it in real life. All right. Oh, Gabriel's about to get sent off. Gabriel's just got sent off. And there's Saka. Alexander Arnold clears for Henderson. Free ball to Firmino. Great first touch. Oh, it's a beautiful finish there from Bobby Firmino. Wonderful stuff. He's loving it. He's loving it. These fans don't care about social distancing. Salah, ball in. Aubameyang clears it, weirdly. Okay, Robertson's got the ball. Milner finds Henderson. There's Mo Salah. Henderson again, Firmino. Fabinho gets tripped up, but Milner! Oh, you beauty! A nice low drill into the corner. That's a lovely goal. Touches the behind the goal here. You beauty, what a goal. Okay, it's Robertson with the throw in. There's Mane. He's in the penalty area, he's going to have a shot. No, lays it off to Fabinho. Alexander-Arnold, a little bit of space. So hit, not a very good one. Renison to Saliba. Finds Bellerin. Milner's nicked that ball. Good interception there. Back and forth between Fabinho and Milner here. Henderson, a little bit of space. Finds Arnold out on the wing. Salah. Alexander-Arnold. Fabinho finding a lot of space there. Unfortunately, couldn't find the net. So, half-time, the XG, still don't understand it. 9 shots, 7 on target, 48% possession, 86% pass completion. There's a few things we need to work on, but those shots and that on target is really, really good. We are going to go with the hands together, I believe, and I'm very happy. Everyone's looking good individually. I'm going to be pointing fingers. You weren't bad, you can still improve. I have faith. Okay, Alexander-Arnold to Mo Salah. Arnold finds a bit of space, runs deep into the box, gets the cross in. One of those really, really poor, scrappy goals that should have been a goal but wasn't. Okay, a couple of subs to make here. I think we're going to go with... I think we're going to bring Divock in. And I want to bring Minamino in as well. Mane's not having the best of games, so let's get Minamino in. Okay, we're going to make our final substitution as well. Fabinho... It's going to come out for Wijnaldum. Okay, Alisson Becker. Short ball to Virgil van Dijk. We're in a very good position here. All of our subs have been done. So we're allowed 2 more because of the COVID situation. I think we are, aren't we? I'm actually curious. I am, yeah. But Aubameyang has got the ball and has managed to slide one past Alisson Becker. Aubameyang putting pay to some lax defending there. Bring on Tsimikas while we're here as well. Several players around him, all on his own up top. Very, very poor by Liverpool. Very poor indeed. Okay, I think I've got a bug here. It's just gone purple. It's post-match. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Oh, I like this. This is much better than it used to be. Oh, he's picked up. It just popped into existence there. Here we go. It's the big one. It's the Community Shield. It's the one that everyone wants. We have won it. Look at the fireworks. Look at the celebrations. The crowd has gone mental. But yes, there we go. We are, of course, the Community Shield champions. It's a champion. It's a shield that everyone wants, of course. It's the biggest trophy in the world. You know, UCL, no one cares about the Champions League. No one cares about the Premier League. Everyone wants the Community Shield. More than anything else. Real Madrid are jealous they've never won a Community Shield. Ever. They've tried. They're not English, so they can't do it. But yeah, there we go. Anyway, we won 3-1. Let's get into the dressing room and have a chat. I'm going to say congratulations. At the end of the day, we did beat Arsenal 3-1. Did concede a goal that we shouldn't have done. But we're good. I am pleased. So many people play big role. Great match everywhere according to plan. He's a good player. Fantastic strike. No questions. Can't speak highly enough about him. There we go. So, a good result in the end. We'll have a quick look to see about the overall stats. So, 15 shots and 9 on target compared to their 4 and 3, 50% possession in the end, 86% pass completion. A little bit to work on. Fabinho didn't have the best game, 6.7. Robertson really didn't have 6.3. But it's one of those things. But I think the tactic is working. Zidane has been watching Bobby Firmino. Well, Zidane can bugger off. So we've opened up with a win. We've only conceded 1 in 5 games. Admittedly, yes, they're friendlies. But we're in a very, very good position. I think the squad is set. I don't think we can, A, afford to buy anyone more. And also, I don't think we need anyone more. I think we're actually in a good position to be done. Right. Talk about rumours linking Bobby Firmino have moved to Barcelona. You can tell him he's not for sale, basically. So, folks, in the next episode, we're going to open up with the first Premier League game of the season, which is actually against Everton. So, what a game to come into. We are going to be playing against Everton in the opening game of the season. Now, Everton, obviously, at the moment in real life, doing pretty damn well. But I'm looking forward to that. I don't know what the fourth episode will be. I don't know when we'll sort it out. I'm sure we will. We'll play through it. I'm going to try and get you roughly 6, 7, 8 episodes of this particular save, because this isn't the biggest save. Before we then get into the 1860 Munich save, if you didn't know about that, we are doing an 1860 Munich save. That is the main save on this channel for the year, probably. Obviously, we've got other stuff going over on Twitch. We've got the Newcastle beta save at the moment. And once Newcastle's done, we've got Boreham Woods, which I'm looking forward to. That's going to be a hell of a save. We're going to be doing a lot more on there. Because I'm going to be more active on Twitch anyway, I'll be on there more or less every day of the beta. And then you'll see quite a lot of me 3 or 4 times a week over there playing the Boreham Woods save when that comes live. So do, of course, like I say, follow me over on Twitch. Descriptions below. Has got the links. The description below has got the link. It's also got the link to my Twitter, which you should follow me on Twitter because you get updates about when I go live and when videos are coming out. Also has the link to my Discord, which you should join because then you get to chat to me and I am gorgeous. And I don't know. Anyway, yeah, just get into the links. Click like, click subscribe, all that jazz. I will see you in the next one where we are going to absolutely smash Everton, hopefully. Take it easy, folks.